is the home of the witches. It's a fortress which Geralt here, I guess it's his home, really. Also home to other witches.
So fast, Roach.
Come into a little bit of a problem.
Come on.
And that problem is that our horse Roach cannot seem to fit through the drawbridge there. But not to worry. Because we can come out here and then via the magic of the Witcher 3, our horse Roach will magically
faster.
There's one particularly fantastic mission, which I'm not going to spoil. was just up there. Just head down this way. There's a small jetty down here. Perhaps this is where the witches do their fishing. Oh, no, it's not a jetty, it's a bridge, actually.
Come
on. It's a bridge with three of the biggest looking bears I've ever seen in my life, just across the from it. Wowzers.
Come on,
big looking bears. I don't think we're going to be crossing that bridge somehow. So I'd like to try and keep these as
come on,
kind of compact clear as I can. It looks like we've got a little pathway down here. So we'll just kind of head down here and see what happens. I haven't really explored too much around this area either. Look, it's a little cave down here.
Hey there.
Did not know there was a cave down here. Let's see if we can get around it.
Come on.
Doesn't look like it. Okay, that's interesting. But the actual
not so fast, Roach.
Looks like I was going a bit too far that way. Never mind, we'll head back this way. The actual next the last DLC, Blood and Wine, takes you to a whole new land. It looks incredible. They've actually increased the kind of graphic fidelity of the game. I don't really know how. This game just looks amazing already. Kind of added in new things, as well as having this completely new area for you to explore, which is just amazing. Distance. Now then, Roach, you'll be able to played The Witcher 1, it actually features the same area. And if you think about how different they look, it's really incredible. I think this way takes us down to the lake, so we can perhaps go for a boat ride across the lake. As long as we can avoid the drowners. Super looking forward to Blood and Wine. It's weird that usually in games like, say for example with Fallout 4, it's got DLC in that, which I'm playing at the minute, Far Harbor, doing a series on that. And it's great, but usually kind of DLC kind of runs along the lines of that. It might take you to a new area, and it gives you new weapons, new armor, and new stories, things like that, but it doesn't generally change too much in the game, whereas the new DLC in The Witcher does change things. It adds in like new combat moves, and just like, I think there's even like a new sign or something like that in there, and like just new things in the game, which, and as I said before, they actually increase the kind of graphical fidelity in the game, which is just incredible. Now that we've got a boat around here somewhere.
Come on now.
Doesn't look like we actually have, does it? Okay, well. There's a little stream here just connecting up to the Great Lake itself.
Faster.
The sounds of that music, that means we've got some enemies. So. Oh, got a drowner there. That's how you escape a drowner. They're probably going to chase me for a bit, so we'll have a little bit of a jog on Roach here. Let him stretch his legs a little bit as he moves. So, Kaen Morhen, no humans,
come
just loads and loads of bears. No, Roach does not like that. We actually need to go around so that I can go back up here. And we're going to have to try and run past these bears again. Hold on to your hands. And there we go. See you later, suckers. Side quests or anything. and yet it's still one of the most beautiful areas in the game. It's just like the makers of this game just saying that it's going to put so much attention to detail in everything they do, regardless of whether it's used for 10 minutes or 10 hours, which is just incredible. Just sailing our way back down to the other end of this, this lake. See the castle in the distance there. The calm waves are looking very, very nice. There's a few drowns down there as well. Just see them lurking in the distance there. Spotting any dangers. If they come running back this way, then we know there's something up ahead. Really beautiful day as well out there. Pretty stunning nevertheless. These deer would make some pretty good eating, I would imagine. But I'm sure there's enough food back at the castle. Is quite battered and old, so it is in need of some repair, but it's not quite what it used to be. In actual fact, there isn't. The witches themselves are not quite what they used to be as well. Don't quite hold the same respect that they used to. Just wander around here. You might be thinking that there looks like there's been some sort of a battle here, and you wouldn't really be wrong either. But I certainly won't say any more than that. One of the fantastic things about this game is that there's virtually no loading screens in it. If you think about by Skyrim, every time you go in a house or a building, there's a loading screen. You know, into a city or whatever, there's a loading screen. But in The Witcher, that's not the case. There are loading screens between some of the regions, but not too many, which is fantastic. There are some areas where you go where there is a loading screen, but obviously something like that in Skyrim, there would definitely be a loading screen. Whereas in this game, just go straight through. Hopefully, with Bethesda's next Elder Scrolls game, I'll have something similar, I think. This is inside the main keep itself, where the witches actually live. Feels a little bit empty at the minute. Just the attention to detail inside here though, the walls and ceilings and light, this is just incredible. It just looks just amazing. But as you can see, it's in a pretty bad state of repair. It needs a lot more work than just a few witches could handle. I love the contrast in Witcher 3 between this kind of cold and run-down kind of castle here and the surrounding landscape, which is just pretty much deserted, and then you go somewhere like Oxenfurt or Novigrad and go through here, and you just see it's just this big kind of juxtaposition between them, which is incredible. And here we are up in the kind of main chamber, I guess, which is where we will call this video to an end. I'll just freaking light that fire. No, apparently not. But that's fine. Thank you so much for watching. I shall see you.